to represent elections on air. It's a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization that is trying to engage voting on politics. The election's coming up.
So one, if you're elected in November, what's your number one priority? No, I tell you, something that I really believe in is trying to make further advances in our community. Expand the number of Americans in Virginia with healthcare, with Medicaid expansion, 400,000 in Virginia. But while we've done that, while kids can stay in family houses at 26, you can't be discriminated against for existing health condition, where they can't be charged different treatments than them, still, we just track Well, I would say that I'm on the health and education committee in the Senate. So we talk about health on education. The area that I work the most in is career technical education. I want to make sure that at the beginning and middle schools, all students have not just exposure to the academic subjects, but to skills and training as well. Because I think we'll make better choices when they get high school and do it for life if they've had some exposure to the world of work. So I want to expand career technical education. I want to work on the affordability of college, guiding staffers. You know, it's interesting in this country, if you're a student and you graduate and you have debt, you can use the bankruptcy laws in the country to renegotiate debts on a yacht, on a casino, on an office broker, but they won't let you do the same thing with student loans. And I think student loan debt should also be subject to renegotiation to make the terms of the better for students, better for those who carry debt loads. So certainly expanding career and technical education, but also college affordability and helping people be able to
leadership. Awesome. Thank you so much.
I really appreciate Jane. Thank you.